Hello!
Morning!
We are at Heathrow and we are just going to do our makeup before we go for some breakfast.
Ready for our day two of the Arizona adventure. Yeah. So we travelled down last night.
Yeah.
The four of us in the car. Natalie was asleep for most of the journey.
I was tired.
She was a great passenger to have in the car.
I was tired.
I know. I brought my little sample mascara.
I've got the, I'm going with honey beige. On the face.
Look at all these people up early in the morning.
I know.
What are they doing up and they're not going to Arizona?
I know.
Crazy time. So we've had quite a funny adventure so far, haven't we?
Yeah, we have. We have. We've had...
Should we tell the suitcase story first?
Yeah.
So a few weeks ago, we all decided as a four that we were going to be travelling down.
Just gonna turn the music down a bit because we feel like we're shouting.
Is that right? Yeah, so a few weeks ago we decided we're all gonna travel down as a four. And we were gonna come in my Mercedes, which was fine, but it's not the biggest. So we said, having four suitcases, we're gonna be a posh. So I spoke to Jen and Ian, got down some suitcases from the attic, and we did like a trial run through in the car. And just realised I'm like half a face on your one.
I can hear you.
Yes, we did a trial run through in the car. There we go. And we figured out we could only just get two suitcases in the boot, one in the back between the two people in the back, and then like a tiny one. So I said to Jen, well, we don't need much, we're only going for a few days. So I said, I've got a small, medium and a large suitcase that all fit into each other. And I got the small and the medium out, and I went to give her the medium and me keeping the small one, and I used the small one for hand luggage, and then I decided at the last minute to swap them. I was like, actually, you have the small one and I'll have the medium one. Jen was like, oh yeah, that's fine. And she was like, will it be big enough? And I was like, yeah, because I will make sure that everybody's got a small suitcase. Like, mine will probably be the biggest out of everybody's. And she was like, okay, that's fine. And so we told Natalie and Kelly, you need to have a small suitcase in the car. So then last night, Natalie got to my house with like the world's biggest suitcase.
No, hang on, it's not the world's. It was...
The United Kingdom's biggest suitcase.
What happened was, I packed my things and I was just struggling to get it shut. So I thought, well, I'll have to swap it over for the bigger one. Simples.
So she gets to my house first, and obviously there's my suitcase, and we only just get the two in the boot, and the boot wouldn't even shut. So I'm like really trying to force it. Managed to get the boot shut. So we're like, I don't know. And I said to Natalie in the car,
I was like, Natalie,
I'm like trusting in the universe, but somehow or another we're going to get all of these suitcases in. I was like, Jen and Kelly have only got small suitcases, so it'll be fine. So I'm like, okay. So we travelled over to Bord, it was like an hour later, and we got to Kelly Bromley's house first. I opened the front door, and she had an even bigger suitcase.
Yeah, so I didn't have the world's biggest case.
No.
Kelly Bromley did.
Kelly Bromley did. I thought that I'd seen the biggest suitcase in the world, and then I saw Kelly Bromley's, and poor little Simon trying to like manoeuvre, and I was like, there's no way that's going to go in the car. But he manages to get it into the two people in the back, so like in the middle, like the middle seat, just, I don't know how. And we were like, there's nowhere for Jen's suitcase to go. Like, nowhere. It's going to have to go on someone's knee. There's just no room. So we get to Jen's house, and who thought it was her hand luggage?
Me. I walked in and I looked at it and I was like, Jen, where's your case?
I knew that this tiny little case was her suitcase because obviously it's mine. She's borrowed it. It's my hand luggage case. And that's what she was using as her main suitcase. And I started laughing, and these two were like, where's your suitcase? And I obviously knew because I knew it was, and she was like, it's there. And they were like, is that not your hand luggage? And she was like, no, that's my actual case.
And she was like, why? Is everyone else's case really big? And I was like,
we were like, no, we're just teasing you. Like, everyone's is the same. So we were all laughing, obviously, like, inside joke. Jen's like, I don't know what's going on with them lot. And then we were like, Jen, I think you've been shafted big time. And then she realised that she's got like a suitcase that's three times as small as everybody else's.
Oh, poor Jen.
Poor Jen. But we managed to get it in the car, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. We got it in.
Your suitcase.
Well, we easily got your suitcase.
Your hand luggage bag.
It wouldn't have been a problem though, because I could have sat on somebody's knee. It's that small.
Yeah, that's right.
Luckily, I've got serious packing skills.
Yeah. Serious packing.
And then what was even funnier was when we got here and she realised what everyone else had actually packed, because she had to pack so light. She could barely put anything in her suitcase. She literally had to have just sample strips of like product because she couldn't get anything else in it. And then Kelly Bromley pulled out a yoga mat. What else came out? And she was like, how did you
bottle
get
of Prosecco.
Two bottles of Prosecco.
I did get a bottle of Prosecco in my case.
Oh, did you?
So she's wearing the knickers inside out, but she got the Prosecco in.
So we were having such a laugh about that last night. And then we got to the hotel room. Then we got to the hotel room and we'd only booked for two people in the room because, you know, all rooms are like just two double beds. We're like, oh, we'll just book for two double beds. And it'll be fine. So me and Kelly Bromley went to go and check in while Natalie and Jen went to go and get food.
Yeah.
And that was quite hilarious in itself. And then we got to the room and we realised it wasn't two double beds, it was two single beds.
So we've all been snuggled up really toasty this morning. And last night.
Last night.
Yeah. And Jen's got a slight issue with touch, so obviously she was screwed next to me because I like to cuddle.
Knows all about.
I like to cuddle like a bear. And yeah,
it was. I can't share your Natalie live video.
Oh,
I know. I wanted to share it. Should I see if I can share? Are you recording yours, Danny?
Yeah.
Try and share.
Yeah,
it
so
again.
Last night we were laughing our heads off, like belly ache laughing, mainly because of Jen's suitcase and Jen's personal touch issues.
But I've helped Jen, her overcome this issue now.
Yeah.
By putting her cold feet on Jen's bum. So she didn't have a choice.
She's going to be region now because she's overcome some personal development issues.
Some personal boundary issues.
Personal boundaries. She's now one of my
fear,
way.
Natalie. Psychology, that's how you deal with it. Like if you're scared of spiders, you're meant to sit in relationship.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I've totally...
When you're scared of people touching you in the night, just sleep with Natalie.
Sleep with me.
You could make a business out of this, Natalie.
What should I call it?
How many men would be like, oh my God, you got to sleep with Natalie Crawford last night. And I'm like, don't touch me.
What could I call it?
Sleep with Natalie.
Yeah, that would
be. Instead of waking up with Natalie, sleeping with Natalie.
Sleeping with Natalie.
Yeah, that would be good, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I think I'd rake in.
So what are you most looking forward to in Arizona then?
Oh, Sedona.
Sedona.
That place. Yeah, I think I'm really looking forward to that. What about you?
So this is my third annual trip going to Arizona with work. I can't believe I paused. I know what I'm really looking forward to. Meeting Rita Davenport. I had to think then, and then it came to me. Yeah, meeting Rita Davenport. She is a lady who was already so famous as a talk show host. She's an author. I've got a book with me. She's a comedian. She's absolutely hilarious. She's a bit like Connie Podesta. I think they're really good friends, actually.
Connie Podesta.
Yeah, they're really similar.
She is something else.
So I've never met Rita Davenport because she then became a consultant with the company and then was promoted to being president of the whole company. But she retired before I began my journey. So I've never actually met her, just seen videos of her and read stuff about her. She's just incredible. So she's the keynote speaker, isn't she? Along with Miranda Bertram. Yes. Two keynote speakers, isn't there?
Yeah.
So that's what I'm most looking forward to. What about you, Jem?
I am most looking forward to all of it. Oh, God.
What if you had to choose?
What am I most looking forward to? Meeting Rita Davenport.
Yeah.
That's going to be incredible. Going to Donna's house again.
That's going to be amazing.
To Sedona.
Yeah,
that's all of it.
Yeah,
that's mine as well.
Yeah, Kelly, you were going to be next. What are you looking forward to?
Meeting Rita Davenport because she is just my hero, and also Miranda Bertram, who we got to see do the keynote speak at Vegas 2016. And she did things to me. She touched me in ways that no one else has ever touched me before. She was amazing.
Yeah,
and I need to meet her. I need to thank her for that. Rita, I need to meet Rita because she's just incredible.
She's mouth of the south.
She's just amazing. And do you know what? The whole atmosphere, the whole everything in Arbonne, Arizona, is just I just want to live there.
Yeah.
It's incredible. It fills me up.
Kelly and
I'm looking forward to my hobnobs.
They're chocolate as well.
They're vegan ones. Wow. Vegan hobnobs. Chocolate chip ones.
Kelly and Jen went to Arizona last year. So this is your second annual trip, isn't it?
Yeah. It's gonna be amazing. I'm really looking forward actually to spending some time with Natalie Crawford.
And learning how to do selfies.
Learning how to do model posing selfies.
That is hilarious.
And just absorbing Natalie's energy. Because obviously Natalie's just gone to Aria.
That's why I'm sat here.
She's really, that's
like
another good
absorbing
thing.
The energy around you. That was me absorbing. Did you get that?
Really? Is that what you call absorbing?
Oh, some might call it dry humping. I'm not quite sure.
Yeah, it's going
to
be...
What are you talking about? Fun? This is a very serious work holiday. We are off to
work
do some
holiday.
Work.
What business trip?
Yeah, business fun.
Business.
Yeah, definitely.
Did you ever think this time last year?
No, I didn't. Absolutely.
What do you think I was going to say? I could have been saying anything.
Did you ever think this time last year?
I was going to say, did you think this last year you'd be watching Wake Up with Natalie? No, I was going to say about Arizona. Did you think?
No. I didn't think I'd be as far as... As far as I am in my business.
Did you not?
No.
Had you joined
Arbonne
then?
I joined, well, it will be a year in April. Yeah. 1st of April I joined.
So no, you weren't even in.
So I wasn't even in.
Do you remember me going to Arizona last year or not?
No. No, I don't. All I remember is Vegas. Yeah. I literally, you signed me up.
And then I went to Vegas. I went and did a launch for you. And then I went to Vegas.
You were saying, oh, I just signed this girl up and now I feel bad because I've gone to Vegas.
Yeah. You should feel bad. I was all left on
the time. I did, yeah. But I still had fun in Vegas.
We had so much fun.
I knew you'd be fine.
Yeah, it was
this
fine.
Is our Vegas song now that you can hear. Mm-mm. Cupid Shuffle. It's Danny Carey's favourite song.
Yeah. Is it?
Does he hate it?
Yeah.
Oh, Ian likes it.
Oh, he hates it.
Ian will be really sad when he finds
annoying.
Out.
Has anyone got any oil?
Facial oil?
Yeah.
No, because do you know what? I bought some in Las Vegas last April and I've only just run out. That's how long it's lasted me. Yeah, do you remember that facial oil? Can you remember when you were about... Well, I enjoyed yourself a bit too much when you found out that facial oil had been launched.
Yeah.
Can you remember?
Yeah. I was absolutely...
You were very excited.
Yeah, I was.
I don't think I've ever seen anyone so happy in all my life.
I still am so excited about the facial oil.
Do you remember when you'd first started and you were like, oh, I absolutely love everything, but what would do it for me is if there was like a facial oil.
Yeah, and then what and came then, out?
Yeah,
a facial
like,
oil.
Oh my God.
I was.
You were probably the most excited person in the whole of the United Kingdom.
Do you reckon?
You were very, very excited.
I was the most exciting person. Good morning, Hayley. The most exciting person with the in the United Kingdom with the biggest suitcase in the United Kingdom.
Do you know what? You've got some world records going on,
haven't
you?
I?
Yeah.
Wow.
You're very extraordinary.
Do you think?
Yeah. I think you should write a book.
Well, do you know what? That brings me on to my next subject.
And I think it should be talking about facial oil and suitcases.
Yeah, well... Yeah, we'll be
Jen should write a book, How to Pack Lightly. Bloody hell, that was a skill in itself.
Yeah, definitely Jen.
Never mind going region.
From Kelly Bromley. Roll clothes. Yeah. Around your bottle of Prosecco.
Yeah.
That's
that is amazing.
Tip.
Eye primer.
Love. I'm just using my eye primer. How
are you?
I've got a best put some makeup on then if everybody else is. Sort of brushing my hair.
I don't know the song.
No, have you not heard it before?
It was really big in America when we were over there last year, but I've not heard it in the UK. Apart from the time, do you remember, Kelly? I was in that cafe and I messaged you and this came on.
Yeah, how
pressing my eye primer in.
I see Jen's head there, look. There's Jen.
The gorgeous Jennifer Cowie.
Now going to do hair makeup.
Who has overcome.
I've got a top tip for you, Natalie.
Yes.
Your primer runs out.
Yeah.
And screw it.
Oh yeah, do that anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get a cotton bud in and get tons out.
I just stick it into my brush in.
Well, yeah, I do.
Brush, yeah. And your foundation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Top tip there. And if you've got a CC cream like this, once you've like, this lasts me ages, one of these lasts me about a year, then what you do is you cut it open, and then just
and like toothpaste and stuff like that, you put it and get loads more out.
You should change this to like budget saving tips with Natalie.
Well, you've brought that into the show. That's not
am I? You're like budget saving.
Yeah, budget saving buddy.
Everyone likes to save a bit of money, don't they?
Yeah, of course.
Save money, make money.
Yeah, absolutely. All day long. Okay. slight contouring down the nose.
How do you feel about the connecting flights?
I'm actually, flying doesn't bother me, timings, whatever. I know I'm going to get there. And I actually like the flying experience. So whilst it's going to be a really long flight, oh my, now this is my like Roadhouse days.
Yeah, this was always played in Roadhouse and Tubes, wasn't it?
Mm. My days.
For anyone that's from like Melton, I'm sure you'll recall. Jen, have you ever been to Tubes?
Yeah.
Have you?
I started going to Tubes when I was about 14. Oh, if my mum was watching this, I didn't.
This is what I
do for the
size too.
Do you?
Yeah.
Can you show us a little bit on Wake Up With Natalie?
Do you want me to?
Yeah. Come and do some.
Oh, I can't do it there, I've got no room.
Just do it on the bed, because we can see Jen. We can see Jen,
we'll
do it on the bed.
Camera.
I'm trying to do my makeup though.
I haven't got a very supporting bra on. I can't do it now, hang on a minute.
Yay!
Go Jen. Oh no, Kelly.
You're going to have to teach us a few moves.
Yeah,
wow, amazing. Bit of a exercise video for you as well. You've got top tips, budgeting tips, makeup.
People are getting a lot for their time this morning, aren't they? Do you know what? I think the most precious commodity in life is time, because I don't think it's money, because although money is fantastic and you can do a lot with money and you can help a lot of people, you can always make money, but time, you'll never get time back. Once you've given up time to do something, you'll never get back. So if you've spent 20 minutes this morning watching us yabber on, you'll never get that time back. So I hope it's been value for your time.
Yeah,
well, this is like Jerry Springer's final words.
Absolutely, of course. If you wake up with Natalie, why would it not be valuable?
Well, because you've got his chumps on it. It's not like your normal professional style, is it?
Well, I like to mix it up sometimes. I like to show the other side, how the other people live. I like to add a bit of variation.
I wonder if Ian's awake yet. He's always tuning into you.
Is he?
Yeah, he loves watching you.
Well, he's waking up with me, does he?
He takes full ownership for you, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. He thinks I'm his little.
Does he?
Yeah, he does.
He's always saying to me, like, are you going to say thank you? And I'm like, what for? And he's like, for introducing you to Natalie. I'm like, well, you didn't. She contacted me. Didn't go through you, did she? And he was like, yeah, but you wouldn't have known if it wasn't for me.
Why is that?
Because Natalie and Ian go way back when.
Oh, really?
Yeah, did you
not
know?
That way back.
No.
Yeah, they go way back when.
We didn't share. No, not like me and Jen. You used to walk home together from school, didn't you?
Yeah, we did.
Oh.
Yeah. I know, he's sweet, isn't he?
Why did you not contact Ian then?
I don't think she liked him.
I didn't say that. No, I didn't actually know that Ian was really doing the business.
Ah.
To be honest.
Why is that? Because it's not on his Facebook.
Yeah.
Oh,
would you have done?
Yeah, of course. I'm not sexist.
Well, that's good.
Just so you know that.
I know. You haven't really had a chance to talk much on your wake up in that.
No, I haven't really. I haven't bought any lip liners.
Oh, we'll use mine, here you go.
What colour is it? Because I'm wearing poppy. It's berry.
Oh, I'm sorry, beggars can't choose it.
Okay, right, we'll see how we get on then, shall we? I'm probably better off with a brown. Maybe.
Jen, have you got a lip liner?
No. Or Jen, have you bought oak?
She probably couldn't fit it in.
Have you bought oak eyeshadow? Or buff?
No.
Are you
buff? What? Foundation?
Bluff.
Oh.
What?
I bought truffle.
No, it's too dark.
Oh, I love truffle and quartz. Those are my favourite combination.
Okay, so I'm using a lip an eyeshadow.
Laura Pop and Ross has popped on.
I met
Laura for the first time in Arizona 2 years ago.
Did you?
Yeah.
Yesterday, the 2nd of March.
Is Laura coming?
No.
I think today is the 2nd of March.
Why? Today is the 2nd of March, yeah. Sorry, I was just checking for my phone.
Oh. Hi, Laura.
Oh, hi.
Hi, Ross.
How's London? Oh, no, I've made a mistake.
You tell us how London is, Danny.
Yeah, how's London?
How's London?
Do we drink the water in London?
I asked Jen if we could drink the tap water. because we're at a hotel at Heathrow Airport, and she said, no, you need to boil it first. I was like, oh, and in my head, but you never said that. In my head, I was thinking, oh, that's a shame, because I could really do with a cold fist it, but I'll have to just make do with a hot one then. So I had a hot fist it, which is fine, but I would have preferred a cold one. So I was drinking it, and then Kelly Bromley came out of the bathroom with a load of water and a glass. I said, where'd you get that from? She was like, the tap.
You didn't think that,
and
I was joking, by the way.
I was like, Jen said you can't drink the water out of the tap. And then Jen started absolutely creasing with laughter. And I was like, what? And she was like, I was joking. You can drink the tap water in London. She was like, we're not in a third world country. And I was like, oh. I didn't know.
Oh.
You haven't told the lock story.
Oh, my locksmith.
Oh, the locksmith. You tell it. So you tell it.
No, you tell it.
What have I got going on over here?
So when we
that's my makeup.
What did we do?
Well, we got here. And Jen was so excited.
Jen, you tell the story. It's your story.
You tell it.
Well, Jen was so excited about her case. And how she's packed it. She was so desperate
to show us. This little hand luggage.
Yeah. She was so desperate to show us. So she was like, oh my goodness, I'm gonna put this on the bed. I'm gonna show you all about my packing, how to pack a suitcase. So we were all huddled around this suitcase, hand luggage. And she was like, right, where's the key? So she got the little key out for a padlock and it wasn't the right one. She's like, oh, it's not that one. Got another one. Wouldn't go in. She's like, oh, it's not that one. She's like, oh, but where is it?
Ask Kelly Bromley for her keys.
So she asked Kelly Bromley for her keys.
Standard lock.
No, it wouldn't go in. So she was absolutely past herself that she couldn't get in this case. Danny thought it was hilarious and decided to take some caption videos and photos for our memories.
What else would you do in that kind of predicament but take a photo?
Yeah, so but Jen was getting very stressed out by the fact that Dan was snapping and she was nearly in tears because Daniella was trying to take pictures and not
taking it seriously.
And it was absolutely hilarious. But anyway, we found the key, but the whole situation was, it was funny, wasn't it?
It was when it was over and I had the
keys. Yeah, Jen
could have. We had to cancel the locksmith from Melton, didn't we?
Yeah. Oh, that was it. So, did Jen say, does anybody have a key? Does anybody have a key, that like a general key that we could try? And Danny went, no, but I know a locksmith.
No, that was Danny. Danny goes, no, but I know a locksmith.
That's what I said.
Oh, I thought you said Kelly.
No, Danny.
I don't know a locksmith.
Do you not?
I should.
They're quite good to know.
Jessica Meach's dad is a locksmith.
Oh, really?
Yeah. This is this.
They're handy to, yeah, it's mine. They're handy to know if you ever, you know, at Heathrow Airport.
I don't think he's going to travel from the Midlands down to London, though, for a suitcase.
Well, you never know. Yeah, you never know.
Depends what. We could have told him some budgeting saving tips and all sorts while he was here.
We could have.
And we had Prosecco.
Yeah.
Which we didn't drink.
Yeah, but it was in the suitcase.
It was in the suitcase. We had my Prosecco.
I think Kelly Bromley thought we were getting on it last night when we all said we needed
really
a drink.
She was really disappointed.
And we meant a water drink.
And she was like, you're not drinking.
We were like, Kelly, no, it's gone midnight. So,
it's time for tea and cookies.
Disappointed.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
After your night, I want to do my eyebrows.
Yeah.
And I need to dry my hair in a second. Can I have the hair dryer, please?
Oh, I forgot you'd done your hair. What time is that?
And I haven't got any mousse. Has anyone got any mousse?
Oh, Elizabeth, we're looking forward to meeting you in Vegas as well.
Oh, wow.
You'll be in for a double whammy because we'll be together.
Natalie.
Oh, and AJ. Happy birthday for the other day, AJ.
Got the hairdryer.
Natalie's
just getting out.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, it's attached.
Oh, it's plugged in. There you go. It's got a long table.
Here, you can sit here though because I'm finished.
Are you?
Yeah.
Well, hang on. We'll have to say goodbye to wake up Nasty because we can't have that blasting, can we?
I know. That's what I thought. I'm really sorry.
Do you need to do your makeup? Do you want to do your makeup first?
I'm all the way in Tennessee. That's amazing. I love how far my wake up with Natalie.
Where is Tennessee, Natalie? In America?
It's in
Kentucky, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, somewhere like outback.
Yeah, where
in America?
Is it in America?
Tennessee.
Please don't do this to me live on telly. On telly, or is it
live on
my TV? Tennessee. Is it not like
It's America.
Yeah. Yeah, it's in America.
We're flying into Salt Lake City.
Yeah, it's in America.
Yeah, I know it's America. I was asking you whereabouts in America it is.
Well, I don't know the actual.
Sorry, I don't know either.
Well then! You're trying to make me look like an idiot. Right, okay, we've quite established me and Danny's, mine and Danny's geography skills are non-existent.
Yeah.
How are my sat-nav skills?
Your really sat-nav skills are good. So yeah, so I'm not finished my wake up with Natalie, but I'm going to have to cut it short because we're in a rush and we are trying to rush and do makeup. We've still got Kelly Bromley that needs to crack on with a mop.
I need to do my mop.
So yeah, we're going to have to go, cut it short. But love you lots, and I'm sure there'll be more videos from us. Goodbye!
Bye!